Acharya Kaka Sahib Kalilkar epitomized truth, love and compassion. People are inspired by a great heritage of truth, religion and culture. It was in this sacred land that the ancestors of Kaka Sahib Kalilkar had settled. There is no historical record of when and how they migrated from the south to the west of India. They were Saraswat Brahmins. In the Savantwadi state of northern Goa, there is a little village called Kaleli. It is here that Kaka Sahib's ancestors came and settled, and it is from Kaleli that they derived their surname, Kalilkar. Academician, freedom fighter, literator and philosopher, Dattatraya Balkrishna Kalilkar was born on the 1st of December 1885 at Gopsal Yadav Pet in the town of Satara in Maharashtra. Coincidentally, it was in the same month and year that the Indian National Congress was founded. Kaka Sahib's father's name was Balkrishna and his mother's Radhabai. He was the youngest of six children. Having learnt a little English, his father came away to Belgaum. Here he got employment as an accounts officer at the office of the Bijapur collector, which was under the British. Dattatraya's childhood was mostly spent in travelling with his father from one place to another. As a result, his education was frequently interrupted. As a child, he was deeply influenced by his mother. The high ideals of his God-fearing parents took a deep root in the child as he grew older. It was Dattatraya who would make all the preparations for his father's daily puja. He would sit with his father for hours and join him in his prayers. The teachings of great saints like Namdev, Eknath, Tukaram and Ramdas left an indelible impression on the young Dattatraya. Nature and her beauty were close to Dattatraya's heart. He would sit alone for hours, admiring nature and dwelling on the blessings she bestows on man. The mystery of the heavens, with its stars and planets, fascinated him. Even as a child, he wanted to protest against the injustices in society. The plight of the poor and the downtrodden would move him to compassion. Right from childhood, he began to protest against casteism, and already the desire to reform society had become strong. In the year 1902, at the age of 17, Dattatraya Kalilkar married Lakshmi Shirodkar. He passed his matriculation examination in 1903 and in 1904 joined Ferguson College at Pune for further studies. It was during this time that great leaders like Lokmanya Tilak gave a clarion call to rouse our countrymen. Tilak's newspaper spread the message of independence amongst the masses. The division of Bengal in 1905 caused a stir in the entire country. Every Indian was pained by the partition. Reacting sharply to this event, Dattatraya adopted the philosophy of the revolutionaries and joined Krantivir Savarkar's organization, Abhinav Bharat. It was Kalilkar's firm belief that such measures could never gain independence for our country. It was around this time that he became friendly with Jeevan Ram Kripalani. In 1907, Dattatreya Balkrishna Kalilkar graduated with philosophy. After this, he worked for a while on the national daily Rashtramat. This paper was subsequently closed down by the British. During this period, he assumed the post of headmaster at the Ganesh Vidyalaya, Belgaum. Later, inspired by Keshav Rao Deshpande, he became principal of the Ganganath Vidyalaya at Baroda. At that time, Baroda was ruled by the patriot king Sayaji Rao Gaikwad, who had made education compulsory for all within his state. It was from here that Kaka Saheb worked night and day for the uplift of the downtrodden, hungry sons and daughters of our land. The sorry state of the untouchables weighed on his heart. These circumstances changed his life and thinking. He resolved to put an end to the atrocities perpetrated on these unfortunates. But when he reflected on the teachings of Swami Vivekananda and Swami Ramtirth, an unshakable faith in God was born within him. He was also deeply influenced by the thoughts of Sri Aurobindo Ghosh. In 1911, Kaka Saheb was shocked when the Ganganath Vidyalaya closed down. His life took a new turn and he became Sadhu Dattatreya. Before leaving home, he told his wife that the children were now her responsibility and that she should not expect any letter or news from him. The income from their farm would take care of her and the children. After leaving home, Dattatreya Balkrishna Kalilkar journeyed to the Himalayas, hoping to resolve the agitation in his soul. He travelled 2,500 miles on foot in the Himalayas in his quest for peace. Sadhu Kalilkar spent nearly 3 years in the Himalayas, in close communion with nature. During this period, he realized the essential oneness of all creatures and the eternal laws of creation. He dedicated himself completely to God. One day he was ordained by the Almighty to return to his own people and to deliver them from the bonds of slavery. On his way back from the Himalayas, he first visited Rishikesh and then went on to Sindh. It was here that he met freedom fighters like Jairam Das, Daulat Ram, Narayan Malkane and Kripalani. From Sindh, Kaka Saheb went as a teacher to Shantiniketan. Rabindranath Tagore was deeply impressed by Kaka Saheb's sense of commitment. Gurudev requested Kalilkar to devote his life to Shantiniketan and he gladly agreed. Gurudev and everyone else there started calling him Dattu Babu. D.N. Pandey has this to say about him. He heard about Kaka Saheb when he went to Shantiniketan as a college student. Kaka Saheb related that Gurudev had once remarked that Lord Dattatreya had 24 gurus and asked him how many he had. Kaka Saheb had laughingly answered that Swami Vivekananda, Swami Ramtirth and Dr. Bhagwan Das were his spiritual gurus. And now Rabindranath was his guru in literature. In 1914, he was working as a teacher at Shantiniketan when three major incidents once again brought about a change in his life. First, Lokmanya Tilak's return from Burma after 6 years in jail. Second, the same year, Dr. Annie Besant brought out a newspaper called New India. And third, Mahatma Gandhi returned from South Africa with a message of hope for the cause of Indians. the 17th of February 1915, Mahatma Gandhi, accompanied by Kasturba, came to Shantiniketan. This historic event was significant not only for the nation, but also for Kaka Sahib. This was the first time that Kaka Sahib met Gandhiji. He listened to him spellbound. The meeting of these two great souls was a remarkable one. It was here that Gandhiji requested Kaka Sahib to join him. Kaka Sahib responded by saying that he did not believe in non-violence. Gandhiji smilingly suggested that he spend a few days with him, and if he still did not accept it, he could always return. Kaka Sahib met Gurudev and sought his permission to leave Shantiniketan. He said he was living only to see India free, and he was certain that Gandhiji would be able to get independence for the country. Gurudev reluctantly gave his permission. Gandhiji also requested Gurudev in this regard. After leaving Shantiniketan, Kaka Sahib went to Baroda to meet Keshav Rao Deshpande. This social reformer's influence on Kaka Sahib was deep. Later, Kaka Sahib Kalilkar came to meet Gandhiji in Bombay, where the Indian National Congress was in session in 1915. Here, Gandhiji's son, Hiralal Gandhi, asked Kalilkar when he could start work with Gandhiji. Kaka Sahib said he could not leave his old guide and mentor, Keshav Rao Deshpande, who would find it difficult to get new workers. Gandhiji was impressed by Kaka Sahib's loyalty and said if only he could get 5 such dedicated workers, India would be free within a year. Gandhiji requested Keshav Rao to allow Kaka Sahib to work with him. Keshav Rao personally took Kaka Sahib to the Sabarmati Ashram, where he handed him over, as it were, to Gandhiji. From this day onwards, till Gandhiji's death, Kaka Sahib served him as a devoted worker. Kaka Sahib was responsible for teaching the ashramites. Living at the ashram, he brought about improvements in the charkha. He modified the machines used for making paper. Gandhiji used to call him a walking encyclopedia. In March 1922, when Gandhiji was in jail, Kaka Sahib took up the editorship of the Gujarati weekly Navjeevan. Kaka Sahib went to jail 5 times in the course of the freedom struggle. During his term in Sabarmati jail, he spent all his time in studying the scriptures and holy texts of various religions. Kaka Sahib's wife, Lakshmibai, died at the age of 40. Kaka Sahib's son, Satish Kalilkar, recollects, when the World War started, Gandhiji said everyone should help the British, and Kaka Sahib was prepared to join up as a soldier. Kaka Sahib's wife heard of this and approached Gandhiji in the ashram after prayers. She said, "Bapuji, I want to tell you that Kaka Sahib and both my sons are ready to join the army, and I will not grieve for this. But you want to send Kaka Sahib to fight for the British, and this will never have my approval." Gandhiji was pleased to hear this.
आप काका साहब को जाना चाहता है इस वास्ते मेरी कभी भी परमिशन मिलेगी नहीं। ये सुनके बापू जी खुश हुए और आपको आश्चर्य होगा कि आगे चलकर उन्होंने रिक्रूटिंग बंद कर दिया।
On the advice of Gandhiji, Kaka Sahib accepted the post of Vice Chancellor of the Gujarat Vidyapeeth. On 14th March 1930, Gandhiji launched the Salt Satyagraha. Together with his two sons Satish and Bal, Kaka Sahib joined the Dandi March. In the year 1930, Kaka Sahib was sent to Yerawada jail, where Gandhiji was also a prisoner of the British rulers. Kaka Sahib had the opportunity to be with Gandhiji for 5 months at a stretch, and this gave him great satisfaction. During this time, Kaka Sahib taught Gandhiji Marathi. Gandhiji used to refer to Kaka Sahib's company as that of a saint.
यहाँ तक कि मैं एक छोटा
Another companion of Kaka Saheb, Tavindra Kelkar, says, Once Kaka Saheb was with Gandhiji in the Yerawada jail, Gandhiji knew that Kaka Saheb would never write anything in his own hand and that he always had something he wanted written. So he told Kaka Saheb that he had made his own timetable and could spare him half an hour in case he wanted anything to be written. Kaka Saheb replied that he had always been ignorant, but not so ignorant as to want Gandhiji to write for him.
बापूजी मैं तो हमेशा ऐसा ही मूर्ख ही रहा हूँ लेकिन इतना मूर्ख नहीं हूँ कि आपको भी कुछ लिखवाऊं।
On November 28, 1930, Kaka Saheb was released from jail. He was elected president of the Hindi Literary Conference at Indore in 1935. At this session, he advocated the use of the mother tongue at the state level and the national language at the lecture level. When Gandhiji led the do-or-die movement in 1942, Kaka Saheb was at the forefront with him. This time, while in jail, Kaka Saheb translated Tagore's Malancha into Marathi and Dr. Varghese's novel Who Walks Alone into Gujarati. This novel was based on the problem of leprosy. India gained independence on 15th August 1947 and Kaka Saheb came to Delhi for the first time in his life. The sight of the national tricolour flying proudly moved Kaka Saheb to tears. After the martyrdom of Gandhiji, Kaka Saheb became totally involved in the Sarvodaya movement. After this, he devoted his entire time to reforms in the national language, script, stenography, typing, and improvements in the telephone and telegraph systems. He contributed a great deal to Gujarati literature. Today, his name is associated with nearly 130 Gujarati, Hindi, Marathi, and English books. In the words of the noted Gujarati literator Sri Umashankar Joshi, in the opinion of great writers, Kaka Saheb was amongst the 10 foremost of our literary figures. When Bapu read Kaka Saheb's book Uttar Ki Deeware in the Sabarmati jail, he was overcome with emotion and hailed him as Savai Gujarati. From 1952, for 12 years, Kaka Saheb was a member of the Rajya Sabha. In 1953, he was elected president of the Commission on Backward Classes. Kaka Saheb visited foreign countries only after independence. Before that, he had turned down every invitation with the words, If anybody asks me in a foreign land, what is your national flag, am I to answer the Union Jack? Kaka Saheb received numerous honors during his lifetime. In 1964, the President of India bestowed upon him the coveted title of Padma Vibhushan. Inspired by the doctrine of equality, Kaka Saheb established the Sannidhi Ashram, which remained till the end the center of all his thoughts and actions. Saroj Ben, treated like a daughter by Kaka Saheb, said that while she was alone after her father's death, God sent Kaka Saheb, and she lived with him as his daughter for nearly 43 years. Many girls like herself used to look upon him as a father. Acharya Kaka Saheb Kalilkar was a devotee of world culture and a source of inspiration. He inspired innumerable foreign students to come to India and to learn the different forms of her art and culture. He respected all religions of the world and believed in the essential unity of all their highest ideals. He gave his life in the pursuit of this belief. After serving his country tirelessly for 96 years, Kaka Saheb died on the 21st of August 1981. by the torch of dedication and devotion that he lit for us, will continue to light the way for generations to come. His contribution to education, literature, philosophy, and the ideals of spiritual equality will go down in the history of our land in letters of gold. Acharya Kakasaheb Kalilkar was truly a Karma Yogi in the highest sense of the word.